Hello, what's happening? What's up? I had Melders, Phaonix, VG Mango, Psycho Sheep, Destruction, Briswith, Neo, Ida, Cutie Pie, Dak Mank, Phaonix. Thank you all for being here. So happy to be here today. And we got a nice early kitty today. Let's lean this way. Look at those jelly beans. What's up, Gruber, Jors, Simahat, Warlord 420, Plax, The One, Bergo, Gossix, Right Clicker, Kevro. Hope you're all just having the best day. I'm so happy to be here. So we got a win on the Kestrel A and the Zoltan A yesterday to kick off our fresh save of FTL. The first time I've ever reset my save in this game. We have quite a few options of ships. We'll get to the hangar here shortly and make a decision. But so many unlocks to go. But 2-0 so far. What's up, Athos, Dualism, Ornuth, Silver Moron, Lactog, Bob Griffin, good to see ya. Let's hop into the game. What a good kitty. What a nice, nice warm kitty. The Kestrel Glaive Beam, or was it the Zoltan or the Kestrel we had the Glaive Beam on? Whatever Glaive Beam run we had was a smashing success. The last, thanks for the 35 consecutive months, one away from that Subscriber Hall of Fame. Much love. Mombe, thanks for the 5 consecutive months. DC100, thanks for the 100 bits. And before the show, BlueSonic21, thanks for the 100 bits. CutiePie, thanks for the 403 bits. And Destruction, thanks for the 140 bits. You guys are crazy. Show's not even live. Thanks for the 100 more bits, DC100. Alright, let's hop into the game here. What's happening, Falas, Dotso, Blackton, Troxiar, Spooky Dodgy, The Prixie. Let's go to our ship list here and see what we have. So we have, this is our, we can do the hangar from here. We've won on the Kestrel A and the Zoltan A so far. So we have Manus, Slug, Rock. NG and Lanius. Maybe Manus will be good. Manus is probably the toughest out of those. Well, Rock A is not a fun ship to play. Let's go for Manus. I feel like that's on the harder side of what we have to do. NGA, Lanius A, pretty easy. Yeah, Manus A unlocks the Manus B. That's true. Let's go for this. What are our achievements we got here? Kill the crew of 20 ships by Sector 6 of the Manus Cruiser. No problem there, I got that. Kill 5 enemy crew in a fight without taking hull damage or losing a crew member while using the Manus Cruiser. Here's a question for the chat. Does anybody know, does that work with the clone bay? Is that an easy way to cheese that? We got the Zoltan B unlocked last night, times 10 power. We got the first achievement, which is kill a ship before the Zoltan shield goes down, and the 29 power achievement on the Zoltan A run last night. No problem at all. Thanks for the 3 consecutive months, and Phaonix, thanks for the 50 bits. Shields up. What should we name our fine vessel here? Throw me out your suggestions. Let's grab this patron name list and work our way through. I believe we're on Silver Moron. No, we're on Bunny Wild. Silver Moron. Amon Fire. And Ephemeral. E-P-H-E-M-E-R-A-L. Just double checking, man. Let's take a look at some of these suggestions. Wow. So many great suggestions. You know, the Crimson Pincer sounds pretty badass. Let's go for that. Nice one, Super Luigi. Does Starship Crimson Pincer fit? That's a no. Nice. Sounds like a solid pirate ship name, and we're definitely always pirates when we're playing the Manus. Here we go. The data you carry is vital to the remaining Federation fleet. You need supplies for the journey, so make sure to explore each sector before moving on to the next. But get to the X before pursuing rebel fleet can catch up. No problem. Okay, let's take a look at our ship and get everybody set up the way we want. So we're definitely going to treat this as a boarding ship. The only mod currently installed Silverwing Poker is the HD Backgrounds mod. Small Bomb is a great utility tool here. We can drop the med bay for that. AJ Saber, thanks for the 10 consecutive months. Like that message. Love, live, lurk. Thanks for lurking, dude. Alright, let's hit this distress here. What's happening? Okay, we cannot afford to do giant alien spiders right now. Sorry. Some sort of giant alien spiders. Some sort of. No, thank you. Not a good enough descriptor for me to jump in there without a clone bay. Whew. Dead jump so far. At least we have a good exit here, I guess. Wretched 23, thanks for the 21 consecutive months. Only three more, man. Okay, we got a civilian being chased down by a pirate. Let's do this. Alright, this ship can definitely hurt me, but I'm gonna hurt them more. Okay, they have a rock and an NG here. Is it better if I run to the shields? No, that won't help us. Sagradoy, thanks for the 55 bits. Appreciate your generosity. It's gonna be better to kite here or just stay the course. Wait for him to lock him in this. We're gonna kite once here. So we're gonna run down to the bottom of the ship. The NG's gonna get here well before the rock. This will give us a 2-on-1 quicker versus the rock. Okay, they hit our shields. That's not great. I'm gonna run to the shield room real quick, draw him over, and do that just to avoid that next laser. Okay, 22 scrap, and okay, they ran away. I can't blame them. If I saw this Manus ship sweeping in, I'd probably run away too. Do I hear fire happening right now? I think I do. What do you think that is? Let's say this room. Yeah, okay, I see. No problem, let's cut the O2 real quick. Let's take it easy, friend. Yes, you will, Dotso, unless you have a clone bay. In that case, destroying the ship, they will reclone. But anytime the ship jumps away, they're gone. And if you don't have a clone bay, you will not get them back. Holy guacamole, Mr. MV, thanks for the 47 consecutive months, dude. Much love, one away from 4 years. I gotta say, I still tune into your stream from time to time, dude. Even though I don't speak very much French, I can listen a little bit. I find your stream very relaxing, dude. You're awesome. Thanks for the almost 4 years. I feel like I have a short attention span when it comes to streams, meaning I'm always hopping from place to place when I'm watching. 15 minutes here, 20 minutes there. Hey, let's aid that Federation ship, though. Okay, this ship, has a med bay. No problem, though, right? Okay, no drone came out. That's good for me. No drone coming out means no anti-personnel drone. They do have a system repair drone. Gotta break that real quick. Okay, here we go. Get dunked on, sons. Dude, they hit the shields again and they're on fire. Incredible. Truly. Oh yeah, lock onto all remaining life signatures and beam them onto your ship. Rebecca, the already fighting skill trained Manus. How are you? Death by Rats, thanks so much for the 33 consecutive months. Much love. Hey, what's happening, Rebecca? Rebecca also brings the scrap to get two shields here. Let's just get this fire under control here real quick. Not sure, True Banana God. I like to do one thing at a time. So right now we're going to focus all of our attention on this run. And when this run's done, we'll figure out where we're going from there. Anything's possible. Okay, no more fire. Good. Get back here, you wily critters. Sir Lagalot, welcome to the Dapper. Much love and thanks for subbing with Twitch Prime. Amber Monster, thanks for the 12 consecutive months. It is amazing how much changes in a year, Amber Monster. Thanks for keeping it dapper. Life is always changing. And here's to another great year indeed. I can say the last 12, 14 months of my life has been very, very impactful. Da-da-da. All right, let's see. What's Rebecca going to do here? Rebecca's going to get named. We're not even at a Sector 1. Here's a couple jumps in. So that's Satralail now. You better believe it. All right, I think Bunny Wild can... hang out in the weapons room here. Bunny Wild was never really meant for combat. Vicious, though. We do have the opportunity here to go double boarding if we grab level 2 teleporting. We have 4 Manus now. Before we do anything else, though, we're going to go ahead and buy 2 shields because we know 2 shields will save our life. The past 2 ships that have damaged us would have been completely trivial if we would have had 2 shields. Kinda hurts to let the distress go, but I think I'm going to. I guess the distress isn't too bad. It just really locks in exactly how many jumps we have. If we go up this way, we can be a little bit more fluid in which way we reach the exit. a little better better read at it. Hard to say exactly how many jumps that is. A lot. Was it 8 or is it 10? 7? More than 6. Could also go 1, 2, 3. Let's do that. Still leaves us enough options. Not sure why I'm trying to talk myself out of that distress, but hey, I'll do it. Okay. I think this is also going to be a store. So what if I go 1, and then I think 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think it's going to be best, because I think this is a store, and this is also a store, of course. So we can get enough scrap to maybe buy something, or trade in for something, could be good. Let's see how this plays out, though. Okay, would have loved to sell drone parts if I had them. Handmaze, thanks for the 150 bits, and thanks for that kind message, man. I'm glad that you and your friends have been enjoying the stream together for so long. That's amazing. That's really what it's all about, isn't it? Oh yeah, that's 2 more for sure. It is indeed Rockjutsu, the first run of the night. Attack the rebels. Get them. Now we got a saying around these parts. No med bay, no clone bay. No problem. So with level 2 teleporting here, we can get in with more manas pretty quickly. We don't need to here. I just wanted to line them up to make sure. You're done, son. Let's steal the civvy supplies. Nice. Didn't get punished. That can be 2 to 5 hull damage as well. Not this time. Hey, you're right, huh, Mace? This is the 3rd basic laser mini beam ship in a row. Buying 2 shields pays off immediately again. I said it before and I'll say it again. Buying 2 shields as your very first purchase is almost never the wrong decision. Yon Ray, thanks for the 5 consecutive months, man. Only 1 more month of that humanitis, that's right. Civilians, hand over the 9 scrap. That's mine. The captain needs that for his mission. Yeah, I don't think it needs to be any tougher, Twinge. I think 2 shields is just too important and also very difficult to get on a lot of ships. Okay, so let's see where this hack lands. Okay, hack landed to engines, that's fine. The ship cannot damage us, so we need to small bomb the shields and then switch over to the basic laser. Oh, you're right, I did. Bunny Wild. Now this will take a minute. This will be a good use of their time for this fight. A little bit of training for them. Okay, shields are down. Good catch there, Bile Hude. Thanks for that. Okay, piloting's down. Nice. Holy guacamole. Penality, thanks for the 26 consecutive months. Streether, thanks for the great half year, man. Appreciate these 6 consecutive months. And Seki Banky, thanks for keeping it down for the past 2 months. Thanks for that love and support. I appreciate it. You cannot train fighting on hack doors. Good question, Smegsky, but no, you cannot. To my knowledge, the only two things that will increase training is destroying something like a drone, another crew member, or a system. Per system damage, per crew kill, or per drone kill too, I believe. I'm actually not sure on that though. Okay, please don't repair the shields. Yay. Oh no. Oh no. Look at those jelly beans. Tough life for cats. Tough life for cats. I mean, like, I know, Winston, but that's right where my head goes. Dude, you kicked me in the back of the head there. We'll try to make this work. How can you disturb a kitty that cute? Holy guacamole, guys. You contact the station once the rebel ship is destroyed. The lone survivor responds. This base is no longer safe. Let me join your crew and I'll have the station's drones patch up your ship. Sounds good. So, I got a free crew member, high scrap reward, and 7 hull repair. Alright, we're definitely going double boarding here, no question. We need to do first, though. Alright. Gonna make this full tour. There we go. Full boarding crew of patrons, beautiful. The Michael 69, thanks for the 26 consecutive months. Only 10 more to the Hall of Fame indeed. You're already living that slug life, man. Just keep on cruising. Okay, so I'm gonna buy level 2 teleporter and a power bar here. Oh man, this is pretty great. We almost have 2 mini manuses now. 4 is kind of what you want. 5 is a little bit overkill, I'd say. Oh yeah, this might be a store. No regrets is what we just did. No regrets. Yeah, I knew it. We got pheromones to sell here. Pheromones do make our manuses faster, but scrap is scrap. I wouldn't say so, William. I mean, I like the HD backgrounds mod quite a bit. I think it's a nice improvement to the overall game. Also, the HD shields is pretty nice looking, but to each their own. I wouldn't say there's anything that is needed to have mod-wise to play FTL. It's a great game by itself. Oh man, the choices. I'd like to buy Burst Laser 1, but I guess too early to buy a weapon. Since we have this 4-man boarding, we can really get by with just a small bomb basic laser for quite some time. The Minstrel, a little hand to you, friend. Welcome to the Dapper. What a name, what a player. Welcome the Dapper. What's up, Athos the Leveler? Always nice to see you in the chat. Twin, what's up, Caden? I don't think we buy fuel here. I think another power bar is what we want. Yeah, Rebel Fleet Pursuit Indicator would be good for a new player. I don't use that mod on stream because I like the guesswork. I think it adds some tension to the decisions because it does for me and the chat too. Definitely, if you're trying to learn the ropes, the flea pursuit indicator give you a much better idea of how to plan out your sectors. Awesome, Minstrel. Well, thanks for watching for 4 years. Appreciate that. You are wonderful. Look at these Pekkas in the chat. Look at them. Okay, well, the ship could get nasty. If I board, I think I can get back just in time, but we're going to go for being smart here. We have this NG roaming repair stuff. We're not going to board because if that bomb hits us, we're done. Please hit. Okay, good. Oh no, not that empty room. Check for fire. There is a fire. Go help him out. You can be his Mantis assistant. All the NG's gonna do is yell at Fultar because he's got tiny Mantis claw hands. Deadly Foxy, thanks so much for the 29 consecutive months. Much love. Oh, it definitely happens, Chamba. I'm not gonna say it happens every time, but it definitely does. Okay, well. That's fine. It's actually safe-ish here. Question is, does this fire in time? Yes, and the shields are down. Nice. I kind of feel like the entity does all the jobs on the ship, while the man is just hanging out in the teleporter. Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Oh, definitely, Twinge, definitely. Still very interactive in that way. I don't feel like the broadcast is any less interactive for me because the cam's off, if that makes sense. Maybe even more interactive in a sense. Okay, right in the med bay, no problem. Wikiati1, thanks for the 8 consecutive months. And Arturus, thanks for the 5 consecutive months. Thank you all for keeping it dapper and making this content possible. You are awesome. Do I hear fire somewhere? Oh man, it's a high level cloak. Fair enough. Only one more shot. Hey, definitely Delbonk. I just feel like since we made the adjustment to doing no cam during the gameplay portion of streaming and just doing it on breaks and stuff like that, I feel like I've had more focus on the commentary and better control over, I don't know, my interactions. Not just from my responses and that, but just how I interact in general with the chat and how I feel about broadcasting has improved a lot, I guess. Much less stress, a lot more good feels, and better interactions across the board. DC100, thanks for the 100 bits. Cheers to you. Sweet Swift Rage, man. Hey, glad you could be here on Creation. And of course, there's a lot more to that than just being off cam. A lot of introspective thinking last year and gained a lot of tools to have a more positive outlook and just be a healthier person overall. Ooh, do I board and look through the survivors? I think, well, we already have 6 crew. Maybe we don't. We kind of have the dream team right here. We can just grab scrap. Give a Mantis a 500-piece puzzle, and they'll make a 100-piece one out of it. Wow, sugar happy, bro. That really did make me smile, man. Just wonderful. You know what else makes me smile? Little kitty jelly bean stretching out. You're so cute, Winston. He's not gonna go big paws for the camera. No way, no how. What a good kitty. I don't know, man. I think going for scrapping the debris here is good. Big paws. I'm gonna scrap the debris here. It's real early and we already have six crew, so. Okay, we're gonna save this guy's position here. It should be a pretty rare occurrence or have them on their system. We're gonna save it there though, and then run them over here for the double boarding strat this way. If we're not going to do boarding, we actually need them for defense. I can just hit return to stations and they go back where they're supposed to. What a sector one. Amazing. Well, I think Manus controlled sounds a lot better than Zoltan controlled. I like Manus controlled sector two a lot because Manus ships often have less offense as a result of having a teleporter. So... generally speaking, Manus-controlled ships usually have one weapon on a lot of layouts, which is awesome. Give me that. Hey, Wormace, nice to see you, dude. Okay, another pretty good sector layout here. Some good options getting towards the exit. Nice spread-out sector. Gonna be able to see the vast majority of jumps, if not every jump, in the sector map. Go 1, 2, 3. Should be able to see all that. Yeah. I think we get to see every jump this sector, which means unless a quest marker takes over a store or something, we should be looking at two stores in this Manus sector. Bunny Wild, thanks for the 39 consecutive months. Appreciate you keeping it dapper. Much love. Du, du, du. Intruders on board. Well, intruders are going to have a bad time here. Hey there. Whoa! You know, I spoke a little soon there because this guy is chunkerific. Okay, you're winning your fight fine. 57-41. 61-45. Let's swap these guys real quick, though, because this guy is no joke. Markle. Primo fighter. Triple Manus boarding party, not a good time. Imagine that boarding party on that Zoltan ship last night, and that event would have gone through the super shield for sure. We probably would have been fine because of venting, but, you know, your Zoltans just can't stand there and fight in that situation. You blink and they're dead. Yeah, good thing we had four Manus there, indeed, Ben. Everything's working as intended. Okay. Hacking lands on the med bay. We're okay with this. These are going fast. Why would you miss? Okay. Oh, no, that's bad. There's fire in there, too. Okay, this is really bad. Oh, no. Oh, no, and the breach? Thank you. This is bad. Internal noob, thanks for the 33 consecutive months, dude. Much love. I'm gonna stay on engines here. My best chance to survive. Okay, we lived. Everything's down right now, so we're kind of hoping for a dead jump. It's almost tempting to jump back to the jump we were at here and then jump back in. I think that's what I'm going to do. We know this jump is safe. Okay. O2's back on. Fires are out in the shield room now. Just check for fires real quick. We got fire there. We got breach there. Got it. Okay, medbay's fine. This is fine. I think there's a fire in this room. Okay, we're gonna run him up to doors real quick. Okay, you're going to... How much HP you got? 20? You'll make it. Start repairing this. Okay, there's fire right there. Breach right there. Yeah, doors aren't down. That's definitely a bonus here. Okay, we're going to vent out everything we can't see. Turn that med bay on. It's closed off. Good. How much else is he? Have 18. Has to run through one mini breach, so no problem. Okay, so that was a really bad situation, but other than that one event that's gone wrong, everything else has gone pretty good this run. We're already way ahead on crew. We have two shields. We had level 2 teleporter. That last jump definitely hurt. I think maybe, even though we missed our shot, firing at shields there was probably better than firing at weapons. It's hard to say, though. Yeah, we're very much okay still. It's very important when you play FTL to not lose your cool in moments like that. Like, if you just say GG there and just, you know, give up and let the asteroids hit you, you've given up your opportunity. Yeah, the repair training boost isn't bad here, I guess. It's not hurting anything. Okay, I think the breach in here is fixed, or very close to. Very close to. Okay, breach is fixed now. Getting his cardio in today. I agree, Fezzik, I agree, and a boarding ship, I think, is the best time to have a little hiccup at the start, because you can recover that with the scrap from boarding. Alright, so we're 3 repairs away from half a repair skill increase on our NG, that's nice. We got lucky that our crew members didn't get hit by an asteroid. The 2 manuses were definitely within asteroid range of dying. Well, one thing's for sure, we're not gonna jump back to that. Hey, we're not even in red hole. We can't say we almost died. Still got 14 hull integrity. You only need one. Seems like the run's going pretty good to me. Alright. No thanks. Been there, done that. Aid that civilian ship. See, this is what I want right here. This is the stuff. Okay, they're gonna board me and go into the shield room? Really? Okay. This is gonna suck for them. They definitely did not think this through. Okay, they're gonna fire the ion stunner, and I'm gonna drop my engines here. Oh no! Not a finger. All right, now we're gonna go cheese up some repairs or some fighting skill here on all of our manas. We're gonna go have a nice little party on their ship. Oh, they're not in the room, right? It's like, why is the teleport not working? Meat grinder, you did. All right, gonna send these guys out, send them back in a different order so he doesn't die. It's gonna do the same thing here. 2-on-1 in the med bay. Manuses should win out almost always. A matter of time. Level 3 medbay can make that not possible. Even level 2 medbay, 2 somewhat trained manuses should be able to out DPS the medbay. Let's get that civvy ship. What you got? Nice double reward. Well, that event right there pretty much makes up for getting wrecked in that asteroid belt. In fact, that little 12 scrap of it brings us back up to Green Hole. Hey, great explanation, Casualty Challenge. Thanks for taking the time to type that out. Always love seeing people answer questions in the chat. One of my favorite things. Okay, let's attempt to download here. It didn't like that. This should be relatively safe. Yeah, this is safe. Okay, so we're gonna drop this right here. We're gonna teleport into the weapons. Here we go. With level 2 teleporter, you can get your guy back with 10 HP. It's just really important that we don't take damage during that time. There we go, so that's out of the question. Drone triple firing can happen, but it's so incredibly unlikely. I don't think so. Okay, O2 is going back on. Let's drop the small bomb for the medbay right now. Just gonna get in there and break the drones, and then we'll hop over to shields after that and load up the basic laser. Actually, I guess shields now and basic laser could work, but this is even safer. If the drone's down, we're 100% safe. Hey, Mr. Smee, nice to see you, dude. There we go. Actually, Mythic Applesauce, a fun note that the type of Kurumbra does not matter for system damage. NGs do the same damage to systems that Manus do. The difference comes in combat damage. So now we're going to board over to shields, and then we'll basic laser the stuff over here. But we snuck a little bit of training in, which is nice. Yeah, these guys are getting pretty close to full. Or one of them is. Saturnalio's stealing all the training then. Aw, dang. Kevin97, thanks so much for the 250 bits, dude. Appreciate your generosity. And Grenache, thanks for the 31 consecutive months. Much love. I think it'd be cool if NGs did double combat damage to systems. Yep, that sums it right up, Dark Twin. Great description. Rock and crystals are the only crew you can board over that need oxygen, that don't die with level 1 teleporter. That is true, Dark Twins. They're already the best crew without that. That's fair. Can you fault me as the player for wanting to be better? I don't think so. I got you, Twinge. I got you, man. I understand. I understand why, fully. NGs are incredibly OP in this game. Fully trained repair NG is really a thing of beauty. Slow and steady wins the race. We hope we don't run into too many automated vessels on this ship. That's the truth. Consultants do no 2 boarding with level 3 teleporter. I would imagine so, yes. With level 3. Not with level 2, though. Be interesting to science out. Okay, we got a store right here, but we got a couple more jumps before we need to go to the store, and I think we should wait. Want to make sure we're closing the gap enough here. We'll go to stress, and then go 1, 2, 3, probably 4, 5. Let's go 1, 2, 3 instead. Got a good feeling about it. Demand a surrender of their goods. Oh, they don't want to fight? Well, that's too bad, because no med bay, no clone bay. No problem. As soon as one of these guys dies, the pilot comes down. We're going to set up for the second set of orders here, just in case it was the 4 cruise ship. But boarding shields here will certainly delay him out. There you go. 4-on-1. Hey there, Chainburst Laser. With the crew dead, you search the ship, you find military-grade weaponry, and take what looks most useful. Was that really what's most useful? Well, maybe to sell. I remember writing vanilla FTL chain laser cells for a good amount. 25? 30? 32? 32, maybe. Good find. A gun is a gun. That's also very true. One thing that the Manus A struggles with is you have this really good early game tool in the boarding to finish ships, but you really have to think the entire run about the flagship fight and how you're going to defeat it. Chain laser could be a piece of that. Could be. Okay, we got a rock there, which means we can get these guys mixed up. Yeah, rock's coming over, but way too slow. Then we just reverse it on them. No med bay, no clone bay, no problem. Well, we got 128 scrap. That means we could potentially pick up cloaking here, which I think we wouldn't buy, but we could. We could. Well, hello there, Flak One. This is tough stuff. We don't need, we don't technically need weapons right now, but that's looking pretty good. Okay, how much is this? Well, you know, honestly, not that expensive to get it to three. Oh yeah, Breach 2 is incredibly good too, Mr. Smee. Breach 2 reduces two levels of shields and causes a guaranteed breach. It's a little bit slow, but it's a monster weapon. No argument from me there. If we had Rock Crew, I'd consider the Firebomb, since we already had the Teleporter. In fact, that'd be really OP. Not even one rock to round it out, though. Well, I think Flak is one third of what we need to defeat the flagship. I think we're going to sell the chain laser right now, pick up the Flak, and get to three weapons. That will give us either Flak 1 burst laser, or basic laser, or Flak 1 small bomb. Flak 1 really helps strip automated ships too, and does help us kill Zoltan ships as well. Okay, let's do it. We're gonna sell the chain laser. We're gonna buy the three fuel here. Gonna do something like that. We're one scrap shy of getting three now, but... Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and buy that. Options. Even being able to have just a small bomb and basic laser on at the same time is comforting. I think one, two, three. Ooh. You look like a military vessel. We're trying to get back to our homes alive and injured by trade, and we could try to improve your reactor if you have any extra supplies. Yes. I do want a reactor upgrade. This is costly since we only have 4 fuel, but we're a boarding vessel. We can make it work. Hey, awesome to hear that, Samsung. Ooh. You recognize the ship as a well-known slave trader. Teleporter. Boom. What's up, Emma? Rock solid. Alright, Emma's got a slot in the shields now. It's only a 2-person vessel, so we're not going to be able to disable their weapons in time, I don't think. Well, let me take that back. We're going to have to. We need the small bomb to land on weapons here to stop the second missile from firing. I don't know, rock on engines actually makes some sense here, or rock pilot could make some sense too. Let's actually do rock pilot. I know we're slightly trained on piloting at this point, but manis suck at being pilots for that reason right there. They're also not good at dealing with fires that happen. So if we can know rock pilot here. Engine NG. And rotate down. Okay, we'll save our crew position here in a second. Hey, right on, Chris Random. I do my very best to start right around the same time every night. Sometimes we start earlier, sometimes slightly later, but always shoot for 7 p.m. Pacific. And if you ever need a time reference, you can do exclaim schedule in the stream. Starting time's always been really important for me. We've had different starting times throughout my career, but I don't think my starting time will be changing anytime soon. Life's pretty stable as is. But I do my very best to remain consistent, because there's so much information and different things you can do with your time. I want to be here on time every day that I can. Okay. Voltar is partly trained. Satrilayla is fully trained. Okay. What am I do for now? Hey, Barkskin. Well, feel better soon, dude. Okay, no abandoned sector for us. Not with the boarding ship. No, thank you. Looks to me like we can hit all of these nebulas, but to what end? What is this monstrosity? These are all jumps we're not going to be able to get to because they lead to nothing. What? What is this thing? Well, let me tell you right now that my pathing just became a lot more important because we're not going to be able to get at least 5 jumps this sector. What a sector. All right, guys, we're just about 1 hour into the broadcast here. I'm going to take a very short break here. There'll be no advertisements for this break. Just going to stand up and stretch my legs real quick, grab some more water. I encourage you to do the same. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here tonight. You are beautiful and amazing, and I appreciate you so much. We'll be back in just a moment to hop into Sector 3. Jeff joins hands. Thanks for the 1,616 bits. Really happy to hear your interview went well, dude. Really happy for you, and thanks for your generosity, man. Congratulations. All right, we have returned. Thanks so much for your patience during that short break. We take about a 3-minute break every hour and a half or so. You know, whenever it feels like a good time to take a break. Breaks are a very important part of broadcasting for me. When I first started broadcasting, I would not take breaks. I'd just power through. A bad idea. Man, which way do we go here? So we know we're not getting these 5 jumps. So if I go 1, 2, I can't even get this jump. So we're not getting these 6 jumps. We're basically going to have to get every other jump. Maybe I won't get this one either. Oh, it's hard when you first start broadcasting. You have a lot writing on, like, your viewer account and things like that. And every time you take a break, you inevitably lose some portion of your viewership. But taking regular breaks allows the content to be more consistent, which over a period of time, not just short term, is much better. Much better. Okay, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. You know, this sector could actually turn out to be really great. I think we're buying level 2 piloting here for the blue event that's probably coming up. We are going to see all the nebulas here. So the manually search the wreckage event is a definite possibility. We don't have a clone bay. So you want the safe option there. But dear God, do you see that I only have 5 fuel right now? I'm going to keep our eye out for some fuel deals here. Fights are good. Okay. How are we going to make this work for us? This is a very tricky situation. So, they have a halberd beam, which means I need to get 2 shields up to be safe from that. If we hit them with a small bomb to their weapons, it would drop the halberd beam and bring the laser up. But how are we going to get the kill here? We could maybe load the flak in time. No. Pumptron, thanks so much for the 500 bits. Appreciate your generosity. Oh my goodness, the level of cuteness behind me is too much. What a good boy. Nice. What a good cat. Big paws. I think I see a solution here. It is a kind of a ticking time bomb, but our oxygen is at 100%. If we load 2 shields and we do the med bay, this will be good training for our crew too. Like, I see this. Okay. We're gonna board into engines here. And instead of fighting here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run around the ship. Let's run around the ship. They hit me there. Do 1. Okay. Okay, so they still have their med bay active, but they're going to fill their med bay, and then the crew's going to die here. And this gives us some time to hit their weapons. Which means we should remove the halberd beam threat. There it is, before our O2 runs out. Safety first. Safety first. Oh, welcome to the meat grinder. Keep it crunchy. With the crew dead, you're able to take the fuel out of storage. You also take all the scrap you can manage. You know, honestly, the medbay here is not that bad of a problem. So what you do if you don't have just this brutal boarding strat is you take two of your boarders and you'd put them in the shield room. You could even teleport your NG over to do like weaker damage. Then you'd have them tank up in the shield room, which is the AI's top priority. And then your other manas would take out the medbay or other boarders. So you can still get the medbay without using a missile. You just have to distract the enemy and take out their medbay behind their back. That was a really good question. Thanks for asking. Okay, we got intruders on board here, but at least we got an award for it. There's many events in FTL that do not give you a reward when you get boarded. Please tell me my guys get there in time. You got this. Nice. Just another day in the office for these manas. You guys need to heal up here, though. Good work, Manus. Good work. We got back-to-back ion storms here. Surely the next jump won't be an ion storm. Surely. Okay, here's why we bought the level 2 piloting. Now we have the blue option. If you do not have level 2 piloting for this event, which is a Nebula-only event, and you choose manually search, you can find a drone part or a crew and scrap. But if you fail the roll, you lose a crew. And you have no choice which crew that is. With piloting, you can just get in there. You're always going to get something. No, you're not always going to get something, but if you fail the roll, you don't lose a crew. You either get basically the same reward, but when you fail, it's not, you don't lose your fully trained pilot or something. That's the worst. Pulse Master Laser is pretty good. Okay, let's buy the weapon power now so we can have Flak 1 basic laser or Flak 1 small bomb. Random spectator, truth be told, we got very lucky on this run to get as many manas as we did. You start with 3 manas on this ship, but we've gotten 2 more. Lucky me. There we go, got some power now. What's happening? Alright, good time for that to happen. I guess run you to weapons. Sure thing, you betcha. How's it, girl? Thanks for those bits. Cheers to you. Luck of the draw, indeed. I'd say you've been exceptionally lucky on this save. It's been, good so far, but let's not remember we did have one very severe event earlier on in this run. Got us down to 14 hull and just a bad time. No shields in an asteroid field. Cooler head prevailed, we got out of there, and the run looks pretty stable right now. I bet manas are pack typers. You know, I used to be a pack typer, the very efficient one. And then one day I just said, why the hell am I typing like this? And I buckled down and learned how to type, and no regrets. Typing speed greatly improved. I obviously don't do too much typing anymore, but You're on the fence, just take a couple weeks and learn how to type. Do it. Or don't, you know, whatever's comfortable for you. Okay, this is a scary ship. We can board this, but dang. Do we? Let's go ahead and slam weapons here and see what happens. Let's get, let's at least try to get those down real quick. Okay, well, burst laser's still up. Red Knight of Cleveland, thanks so much for the 9 consecutive months, dude. Hope you've been awesome. Thanks for being a part of the channel and community for so long. Okay, we're definitely going in with level 2 teleporter here. Take a peek. No fire? Nice. Double NG? No problem. Oh, for sure, Mad God Rando. I don't doubt you. There's nothing, like I said, when I pack type, I was very efficient at it over time. I just regretted not taking the time to learn to type the way I do now sooner. That's all I'm saying. Just saying, give it a try. Chris O'Flux, there are no current planned Cooking with Frag episodes. I think we're on a bit of a hiatus right now, but we had a really great reboot yet again. We keep rebooting the series, and I think that'll probably continue to keep happening. But we're over 60 episodes of Cooking with Frag now. It's been an amazing experience since the 2-year livestream challenge and now. I'd say the last set of Cooking with Frags has been, I think, the most rewarding, so it really got me out of my comfort zone. Took stuff to cook from the Patreon, and that was really nice. Got to expand a little bit, did our first dessert episode and several other things. Another successful Mystery Basket episode as well. Really enjoyed doing that. Well, I do need fuel, and I'm not really using missiles, so okay. Sounds good. Oh, man. Well, I don't want the human. I guess I go for this, right? I think, actually, this might be a ship that's going to be better off to kill instead of do boarding. Unless I want to start rotating out one of the manas. Esquire 14, thanks so much for the 35 consecutive months. Much love, man. One away from that Subscriber Hall of Fame. You are awesome. I'm going to take the blue option. Okay, we got a second rock here. Wow. Rock solid. I think we're gonna board here anyways. Yeah, I think it's gonna be safer actually. Okay, Mantis and NG. Might be more than that. It's the second NG. There's no point in boarding over again. I hope they don't get the other missile off, but it's definitely possible. Warskin, thanks for the 20 bits. Cheers to you, man. Man, I'd like the distribution a lot more if we had an NG. Okay. Got a scrap reward for that too. Who are we gonna rename here? I guess the bonfire's farthest behind. Okay. There we go, just like it never happened. Part of the team the whole time, I tell ya. I turned that bug into a robot. Yeah, I did. Okay, Fultar's now over here. Monfire's now over here. This is awesome. This is a really solid core for this ship. Got some really got tough bodies here. A lot of anti-fire near the engines and piloting. Got easy access repairs to the key systems to keep the evasion active. And now I don't need to save position. Let's see, who's trained here? You're trained, you hang out over here. Bunny Wild's also trained, so these two guys are gonna get on deck here. Gonna put the less trained people in the teleporter now so we can get a core of four fully trained manas. Then we can think about level 3 teleporter. But we're still a ways away from that. What are we saving for right now in Sector 3 that I shouldn't be buying? Probably should buy at least Engine 3 here. Drone control defense drone would be really monster to pick up soon. Cloaking would also be great. It's a good question, the Bower. Bower has to be better to put the NG on piloting. You could argue yes, but I like to have my NGs able to move around, so I like to have them not on the piloting or engines. They make fine pilots or engine people, but then they're not as mobile. Rock's nice because you never really have to move, and if fire breaks out, you never have to panic on a rock, so not taking fire damage. Also gives you good time to react if you get boarded by Mantis or something. That's how I feel about NGs on pilot. They're good, but they're better at doing other stuff. Hey, let's just get in there, attack the ship. You knew it had to have cloaking, so it had that. Small bomb stops the pain here. Looks like they're not going to fire till they come out of cloak, which is good for us. Alright, this could easily be a 4 or 5 cruise ship. They, however, do not have a med bay. We'll be able to board in with our second set in time here. Okay, they got Manus right there. Double Manus. It's not cool. Okay, Manus and a Zoltan. Neat. I guess I'll accept that for now. Nice, sick dodges, dude. Nice. Okay, he's gonna take 15 damage when this guy's explodes. I need to be careful here. Okay. 4 health. Gonna step him out of the room real quick and teleport in. Boom. Oh no. Okay, almost. Okay, he's hurt too. It's fine. Zoltan's coming into this room. Ion's down, let's power on the O2 now. Let's think about how are we gonna get ourselves out of this. I do think moving this guy right now is a valid option. Silver Moron could just head over to the empty room. Let's do that. Let's set up for the end kill right here. Here comes the Zoltan. Boom. I think they have more than this crew left, but let's send this guy out. We'll send this guy in. Send you out and then you in. And everybody back in the room. There we go. Get him, got him, good. There's only 3 crew on that. 6 fuel, 30 scraps seems good to me. Hey, bummer, Arnhems. Maybe next time, dude. Maybe next time. We got shook up in Sector 1 on this ship. Wowza woza. Rolling and scrapping, indeed. We have enough right now to buy cloaking if we wanted to. I don't think we would buy cloaking right now, but it is an option. Hey, awesome. Cool and the gank. I'm glad the videos help you get your win. Really glad to hear that. Hey man, it's a store. You know, why not, you betcha? Now, like, we had a choice in our pathing this sector. We had to take what we get. There's 7 jumps I think we're not getting this sector. Unreachable. Okay, we do have whole laser 1 here. No secondary system, though we don't really need that yet. Could go flak, whole laser, small bomb. I think drone control with the defense drone is kind of what we really want. Hacking would be very useful as well, though. 3 shields is certainly safe. Only Sector 3, though. We technically have all of next sector to get 3 shields. That's true, Nash. Scrap Arm would definitely have time to pay off, but Scrap Arm doesn't really pay off till probably Sector 6 or so here. Maybe before that. I think you gotta get 500 scrap before the Scrap Recovery Arm starts paying off. I gotta note that our first 2 runs this save have had a scrap recovery arm, that's true. Mr. Legendary Ben, I would definitely vote against selling long-range scanners to get shields, but you can if you absolutely need to, and there's definitely a time where selling long-range scanners is the right choice. No question about it. I can't do it. man. How much is it to get one more in weapons? Only 35. Okay, we're gonna sell the basic laser here, load up the whole laser. My three power bars, there we go. Also gives us some options here, do stuff like this, or this, and it gives us an out into three shields coming up soon. A nice solid upgrade. We know we're gonna have offensive options and defensive options. Nordholm, how it works on the scrap recovery arm, it costs 50 scrap. So in order for the scrap recovery arm to make you 50 scrap, you had to have seen 500 scrap for it to give you 10% bonus. Maybe it's a little bit less because the way it rounds or something, but it's right around there. Pew pew pow, pausing is a main mechanic of the game. It's like the most important feature. You can, and I have played no pause, but pausing is a huge part of the game. It rounds down, so you need more than 500. Okay, good to know. Josh Foe, 83. Thanks for the 29 consecutive months. Let's grab 5 repairs. You know, splurge on the ship. Real good. Amazing. Get 3 shields here soon. Maybe 4 or 5 engines. We're in a great spot, even without subsystems. The sector turned out to be way better than I thought it was going to be, just from the force pathing. Okay. Teleporter's not the best option here. These ones that are on stations, the blue option skips past this fight. We want to get the fight and the reward afterwards, not just the reward afterwards. Joshua, 83. Thanks for those 29 consecutive months. You are wonderful, man. Thank you all for keeping it dapper and making this content possible. Combat drone, fire drone. Fair enough. Going right for weapons here. Ooh, why you do that? Okay, so you know the fire drone's doing its job. Thank you. Okay, not safe yet. Cool. Okay. Load the whole laser back up here in a second. Just want to take one more shot at that. Do not go off piloting. Get out of here. Okay. Everything's fine. Where's that fire at, though? Well, this ship makes 3 shields look like a great idea. And I'll give it that. Fire in here. Double fire. It did indeed, Bauer. That fire drone could have been so much worse. We'll heal after the fight here. Dang. Why didn't I fire weapons instead? Okay, we got a map reveal here. That's cool. Oh, we do know we have a store down here. That's somewhat helpful information. So there was three stores in the civilian sector. This area was inaccessible, so it did have some stuff in it, but at least we didn't miss out on too much, just like a normal sector for us. Let's get some heals happening here. Good job, team. Daily Draw, thanks for the 26 consecutive months. You are amazing. He is good. None. We have 8 crew here in Sector 3. We've rotated out 1 Manus for 1 NG already, so we've technically seen 9 crew this run. Nice. Hey, well, sit back, relax, enjoy. Luzz off. You deserve it, man. Take her easy. Yeah, we'll send the rock crew in for that fire suppression. Wow, don't buy a scrap recovery arm when you can get it for free. Hey, third run in a row we've received scrap recovery arm. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I don't think I can go 1, 2, 3 and make the store. I could go 1, 2, 3 and then dive to the store and dive back, though. That's crazy. Pure madness, I tell you. Recon Ocelot, thanks for the 35 consecutive months, sir. Much love. Thanks for keeping it dapper. You are amazing. Yeah, I don't think diving is the right choice here. I think save 3 shields. Or what are we going to find at the store that we really want to get? Long range scanners for sure. Maybe just a minor repair here. Yeah, let's just go 1, 2, 3 and that'll be the safe play. I don't think we can go 1, 2, 3 and safely make the exit. I don't know if that's a dive though. It does look like it's pretty close to being 3 jumps. Not only 3 runs in a row, but 3 runs on a brand new save we've gotten. Scrap recovery arm. Urinal Deuce, little hand to you, friend. Welcome to the Dapper. Thanks for subbing with Twitch Prime. Much love. Light and Shard, little hand to you, friend. Welcome to the Damper. Much love. Thanks for that love and support. It's my honor and pleasure to be here. Grateful for every day. Well, is there any way I can dive here? No. Just play it safe here. There's definitely a time for safety. We're on the verge of... having the run be awesome. I think we definitely could have made it even with 3. Okay. Oh man, Zoltan Shield Bypass, I think might be a must buy here. I guess we can strip Zoltan shields pretty efficiently right now. Nah, we got time for that. Let's buy 5 repairs. Five biggins. We definitely could have made all the jumps, but you know what? No regrets. The Bower, little hand to you, friend. Welcome to the Dapper. Thanks so much for that love and support. And Rasu, thanks for the great half year. Appreciate you keeping it down for the past 6 months. Congratulations, you're cured of humanitis. I'm gonna go no on that one. Well, we're not using bombs right now. Yeah, let's do it. We know hacking's kind of inevitable at some point. It's called a die if we go behind that red line, Brochiman, which is the pursuing rebel fleet. If you go behind the rebel pursuit, you have to fight a ship that is harder than average, and the reward will only be 1 fuel. Well, store makes more sense, doesn't it? Oh my goodness, I missed it. Death Snatch, a little hand to you, friend. Welcome to the Dapper as well. Appreciate that support. Sorry for missing you there. I mean, overwhelming. What's up, Roughneck? What's up, GZ Gamer? Black Bear, Alan Orn, I am the Defiant. Cletus, good to see ya. Yeah, this is too limiting on what we can do. Hey, what's up, human being? Good to see ya. Colonel Lance, thanks for the 100 bits. Appreciate your generosity. Man, do I want hacking. Could have had 3 scrap recovery arms. Yes, you're right. We could have had 3. No, if we would have bought the other one, we wouldn't have the scrap for it now. I don't think. Have we bought anything since then? I mean, now that we have 1, though, the second one almost makes sense, right? Then it's even less scrap for it to pay off. 20% more scrap. Hey, enjoy that lurk casually challenged. That's right, we bought the 10 for repairs only. Could have sold your weapons for the 3rd recovery. Okay, you got me there, dumbass. You got me there. You know what, it's really early into this save and this run, and I really do have faith that we can make this build work. So let's go ahead and do it for the love of fun. More scrap, it really kind of makes it more like we're playing on normal. For the love of fun. Okay, let's just fight here. Okay, that's pretty nasty. If we hit their weapons once, though, we're okay here. We need to make sure this NG doesn't actually get our our weapons here. Ooh, this is tough. Hey, thanks, Peter Cod. Yeah, so the Twitch desktop app is releasing or going into beta tomorrow, I believe, or very soon here. And channel feeds are becoming mandatory on channels. The channel feed is the thing below the broadcast. Streamer can post news about the stream or schedule stuff or whatever. It's kind of like another media feed. I'll be posting one message each day. The message may be varied, could be about the stream, could just be something nice. Well, that's how I'm gonna use it. Gonna recap the show and what's going on. Sarah Tritamine, thanks for the 29 consecutive months. Much love. Okay, get out of here with that. The ship was annoying, but not really deadly. We get hit for one damage there, too. Could have been a lot worse. No! No. Don't bring that back online. It's not what I was talking about. Hey, it's just another way to communicate what's going on with the stream. That's a great thing. Communication's good. Please hit. Thank you. Oh, he got there. What a champ. You don't have to use it, no. Nothing's mandatory. But it's my understanding the channel feed below channel broadcasts will be activated automatically. It won't be a toggle. We unlocked anything tonight? I don't think so, Zephyr. No, no unlocks tonight. We're on our first run. Hey, we'll see if we're doing our achievements. Kill the crew of 20 ships by Sector 6. Gotta be getting close on that. Kill 5 enemy crew in a fight without taking whole damage or losing a crew. That's gonna come later. While using the Manus Cruiser, kill the last enemy with your last crew member on their ship. Okay, if we see a clone base ship, we can make this happen by disabling their weapons and boarding over with everybody and then taking out the clone bay. Got it. Get 2 of those done, we'll unlock the Manus B, my favorite ship. What's up, Run Dude Run? Nice to see ya. Painter Nola, thanks so much for these 16 consecutive months. Much love. I did not see that news, Painter Nola. Calbar 53, thanks for the 21 consecutive months. Love tonight is unreal. Just thank you all for making this content possible. It's my sincere pleasure to be here. Hey, man, that's a nice reveal. Well, knowing that that's a pulsar, we're probably just gonna dip down here. Well, that's an amazing save, not having to see that pulsar. We could hop down and see this store. If we do that, though, we're probably not gonna get to this one. I think for that one, 86er, all you have to do is have all of your crew board the enemy ship. We'll find out soon, though. Just need to find one ship with a clone bay to find out. This is an easy board, easy life ship. definitely can hurt us. Nice. Yeah, that's correct, Twins. That's right. If you can get two of an augment, that means they do stack. So shield, recharge booster, reverse ion field, scrap recovery arm, so on and so forth. But like long range scanners, if you get two, it just breaks it down into scrap. It's a very simple way to differentiate those. Good call. I don't know if I want to go to the sun either, but I do want scrap here because three shields is looking real good. It's actually a pretty nasty ship, but I'm not paying a frickin' toll here. No way. No way, no how. I actually want to go small bomb here. Just want to get these down so I can board into weapons and make it happen. It's a pirate fighter, so no guarantee there is going to be Zoltans or anything weak on this ship. That was pretty sick. That's as good as it gets right there. 5 damage. Yes, you can cloak with your Zoltan shield up. Absolutely. Oh, somebody's got a bad case of humanitis. That's you. No, I missed that too. Okay, fair enough. I could have saved that as well. Maybe next time. Okay, no more missiles. That's good. Yeah, let's just finish this off. You can do it, little Manus. Oh my god, they have a high level med bay. Get them out of here. Get these guys out of here. I would have saved so much more time here if I would have just loaded up the small bomb sooner. Not to mention the hull damage. You go ahead and do that, Heban. It's good. Wow. Okay, I think we're just gonna get the kill here. No, not quite. That wily Heban. Level 3 med bay. I'm not mad, I'm impressed. It's like they were prepared for this very situation from the beginning. What a fight. What a journey. Lavish Inferno 115. Thanks so much for the 5 consecutive months. Appreciate you keeping it dapper. Much love to you. Hey, Pinball Wiz. Nice to see you, man. Hope you're having a good night, sir. I did not pinball whiz. That's pretty exciting. Attack from Mars, a very classic machine. Like, we dropped a decent chunk of frames there. I'll keep an eye on that. Might have to switch servers here. We'll see. You know, actually, I think making this store makes more sense. Can definitely go Nebula here to the store and then over and then make it back down here in a reasonable amount of time. Maybe miss out on this store, but you can see this one now with some scrap in hand. Well, one thing's for sure, we could have handled that last fight better. But we're alive, our hull's green, and we have 113 scrap and 2 scrap recovery arms. Let's prepare to fight. Okay. If they only have an ion up, we want to make sure we're damaging stuff that is not going to take away power. So we're just going to go all in on piloting here. If they only have the ion activated, we can never take hull damage. It could be an annoying fight. Nice. It'll never be dangerous. If we hit their shields here, this weapon's gonna peek out and start hitting us, or they're gonna hack us. But they've decided that the charge ion is their best chance to win versus us, so we're gonna let them think that. Just keep it cool. To the store. What's the best no system damage weapon? Probably ion bomb. No life signs, they said. Fair enough. Defense scrambler, fire suppression, shield charge booster. Well, there's that drone control, but no help on the defense end. Okay. I feel like I'm spending all my extra on repairs right now. That's definitely not the case, though. We're now going to buy that right there. Give me that. 3 shields online. I'm gonna reject your offer. Hey, we can actually, do we need to train here? We might as well. It's 3 lasers versus 3 shields. We are once again immediately rewarded by purchasing a shield bubble. Most excellent. No third scrap arm is what you're disappointed at, Marissa, with. Okay. That's fair. Hey, here's the clone base ship. Question is, can we clown car into this thing? I think we can. Would you rather have cloaking and defense drone or cloaking and hacking? With a boarding ship, probably hacking. Hacking's pretty sick. I think we can definitely clown car this one. But let's go ahead and get our training up here. Doesn't have to be full training. Doesn't have to be, you know, max here. Just want to get a little something going. We could also get max level fighting here. We're not going to do that, though. We have enough training here. I think we're full up on all our manuses now. Should be. Oh, Foltor is not there. Oh, also, you don't get fighting training on Clone Crew. We found that one out a while ago. Sammy74, thanks so much for the 4 consecutive months. Much love. Yeah, it is Bogazine, but you can let the crew, like, repair a system or something and then punch down the system. That's one way to get more training. I think it's just worded kind of funny, Hexofrog. I think what Battle Royale means is, you know, get the last kill on the ship with all of your crew aboard the ship. We'll see how that works out, but I'm pretty sure that's how it is. If not, we'll find out soon. It'll be good training for everybody. Really rare to get a training opportunity this late into the game. And I guess we're only in Sector 4. It feels like later because we're set up so well. Hey, what's up, Bird? Nice to see you. Hey, nice. Almost there. The extra 10% you get from piloting an engine is so worth. KL Thunderwing, thanks for those bits. Do appreciate you. Look at it go. No, it will not, Mike Mirror. We don't want to board O2 here, but that's about it. As long as we don't board O2, so we can board engines, weapons, piloting, teleporting, and shields, it'd be fine. Nice, just a few more here. 3 more dodges for Aki. What a wonderful night it's been. Thank you all for being here. What a lots of great interactions in chat tonight that I've seen. Thank you all for being so wonderful and awesome to each other. It's great to see. All right, so we're there on that, so we can drop this now. I guess we might as well get shielding. It's only 10 more. Whoa, We'll wait for him to finish. Two more volleys, man. Two more volleys. There it is. Ding! Alright, here we go. Time to give him the old clown car. This is a classic Manus maneuver. Anytime they see a clone bay, this is the play. Get in the old clown car. Mantis are professional griefers, yes, true. Hey, look at that. Okay, that's good. Oh, I think we might have lost out on the achievement, though, maybe? No way. You guys go in here, and you guys go in here. What's happening? Alright, this is it right here. Let's get it. Tickle squad, activate. Give him a good tickling. That's right, poke him in his little tummy. The amount of tickles will be overwhelming. Tickled to death. Okay, we got the trustworthy pilot one. But not the other Chivo, fair enough. Well, now we know, so Battle Royale really does require it to be your last crew getting the kill. Now, since we got a Vasty Scurvy Dog there, was it possible for Battle Royale to happen there? I don't think so. Maybe the original crew needed to be alive to count as the, you know, the normal crew. Maybe. Okay, let's read the achievement here. While using the Mantis Cruiser, kill the last enemy with your last crew member on their ship. I don't think everyone else has to die. I don't think that's right. I think you just have to have all of your crew members on the ship when the last crew member dies. Okay, I think I understand now. Got it. Okay, our other one is kill the crew of 20 ships by Sector 6. We can definitely get that. We're not quite to Sector 6 yet. I'm surprised we haven't got that. The Only Sector 4, though. Got plenty of time. Plenty of time. Black Gun Mark 1. Well, that is, let's say, convenient. Would you like double your flak power? Yes, I would. Thank you. Yeah, that's a cool background right there. That's a good one. I agree, Ninja. I don't see this one too often. I mean, that's all right, I guess. Thanks. Destrina, thanks so much for the 47 consecutive months, one away from 4 years. You are awesome. Much love. I don't know. I'm not going to do that. Investigate. Try to communicate peacefully. Okay. Triple flak, triple scrap. Well, that is the dream, isn't it? I think 6 for 24 here is safe. We don't have hacking yet, and we're not really going to need it. We're not going to be super relying on it with a good weapon system. Sell 6 for 24. Not willing to sell 12 here, because who knows? Whole repair drone could be a thing to make for some cheesy fun. He's holding controlled. Phoenix, thanks for those 50 bits. You gave me old noodle arm there, sir. Good job. Alright, exit in a nebula. That's cool. Yeah, you got there. That is what counts. That's right. Let's save enough to be able to buy hacking here. Send the rock in, man. Bam. Augment stealth weapons. Okay, well, that's something I could sell later. I have absolutely nothing against Noodle Arm, Smug Sub. Don't read too much into that statement. You're a valued member of the team, sir. Delano Dines, thanks for the 25 bits. You guys are nuts. Intruders on board. Well, I gotta tell you, these intruders are gonna have, not the time they envisioned. Yep, it was going okay for them. But not so much anymore. Ooh, there's 6 boarders here? Get them out. Oh, there was 5. I shouldn't have taken a whole damage there. If I was a little more aware, we would have got that one. No store yet. Interesting. Humanitis exterminated. Well put, Magic Cut. Hey, you're gonna get there, Bender. It's only a matter of time, and if you keep playing, you will get your victory. I promise you. Okay, that is an energy fighter, indeed. Dark Lotus Subset Games just announced their second game, Into the Breach. That's command, there we go. They've also talked about doing one more patch for FTL, but they've long said that this game is done being developed. Now they're working on a second project at their own pace, and I can't wait to see what it is. Can't wait to play it. Okay, we managed to dodge the halberd there, nice. Okay, I wish I could see inside this energy fighter. I know it's two Zoltan in there, but... I mean, there's a chance we can kill the Zoltans here, but probably not that easy. Whoa! He got liquefied, man. I take that back. He's done. He's done. Get him, got him, good. You find a weapon system on their ship with no crew to stop you, you can install it on your own. But we won't, because it's a Hermes missile. So we will gladly sell that to the nearest vendor. Mike Marin, we reset the save at 1940 hours. We're currently at 1952 hours play. So sometime in the next month, easily we'll hit should hit 2,000 hours. Hey man, there's that store I was looking for. Do we want to hit it now? I think we do. Patton TV, thanks so much for the 11 consecutive months and that incredibly kind message. You keep watching, I'll keep streaming. There's drone control and cloaking. Wow. Congratulations. Coolie Sim, and thanks so much for those 100 bits. Congratulations on your Zoltan Sea victory. Okay. The problem with the Hermes is it costs 3 power for 3 damage. It's somewhat quick charging, but it eats missiles really fast, and a defense drone just stops it dead in its tracks. Chose God, thanks so much for the 47 consecutive months. My goodness. One away from 4 years. Insanity. Yeah, indeed, Thaddeus. But we have a few options here. We do have the weapon set up that we could go a more offensive build versus the flagship and just kind of start boarding the ships that are convenient, but really want to max my scrap with double scrap recovery arm. I would rather have a free slot for augments at this point. We'll probably end up finding an augment from something. And really, the only thing to fill this last slot is probably long-range scanners or a third scrap recovery arm. Hermes gotta go. Double flak hole laser is just not that good. Double flak fire beam would be really good with rock boarding. Could be decent anyways. Hold on, does double flak fire beam make way more sense than it should? You can ditch new augments when you get them, cool in the gang, but you're throwing scrap back into space when you do so. No, Firebeam does not make sense here. We got 4 fully trained Manus. We didn't have Manus, then fire strats make a ton of sense. not good versus auto ships either. I think actually our best choice is just to bring the whole laser, which we already own, into this build. Like so. There's 8 projectiles, good enough to take down med bays and stuff. Easy peasy. Definitely want to buy some fuel here too. Can we give up the small bomb right now? A double flak one, I think we can. Is this just as good? I think the hole 2 has fire chance as well, Ogie, is how it works. How much for our next weapons? 50 and 75, so 125. Okay, I'm gonna do it. We're gonna sell the small bomb. We're gonna load the whole laser here. I'm going to buy all 7 of the fuels. We're gonna buy drone control here, because defense drones are cool. We're gonna buy 2 power bars and 1 weapon power. This gives us some protection here. Defense drone flexibility with 3 shields and 2 teleporting with our 4 manas. Say we're set up for success. We want to buy 1 more in weapons. Definitely get up to 5 engines here, too. Probably just roll with the double flak and get up to 5 engines. Then maybe 3 teleporter. Defense drone's great for boarding because when you board, there's often extended fights. You know, you have to board with the second set, so it's, maybe fight lasts a minute and a half or something. Defense drone's a lot safer than cloaking in that chase. Hey, there we go. Azoltan Academy sits docked just outside the beacon perimeter. They're happy to show you the fruits of their labor and offer something to take home with you. So since we sold our stealth weapons, we didn't have to drop that battery charger on the ground. We can turn that into 20 scrap at the next store. Phew, man, that's tough. Okay, though. I'm just that kind of guy. Yeah, that's right. You give me scrap as payment. Okay, if I'm gonna get stranded here, I want to get stranded inside the nebula. Goodness, this is happening to me. Little kitty jelly beans kicking me in the back of the head all night. What a tough life for kitties here. I know, buddy. Life's hard when you're just a little baby kitty. Life's hard. Chose Gob, thanks so much for the 47 consecutive months. Much love, and thank you everybody for being here. You are awesome. All right, so five laser ship with cloaking and a med bay. No way. Sorry for not seeing you there. Sooner chose God. Thanks so much for the almost 4 years. Or maybe I did and I just psyched myself out. Probably did. So you all know my my own personal nightmare is missing resubs and stuff. I always do my best to verbally give people recognition for their support. All right, they only got level one doors here. We can get in here and start causing a ruckus. Also, don't want those weapons repaired so much. Whoops. All right, well, I got you twice, Chozgob. There we go. Welcome to the meat grinder. Okay, that's not gonna work out then. Okay, let's get these guys over here, huh? Med bay's gonna fill up. Fill up. Hey, only level one med bay. Nice. Okay, this guy can finish off him. You got that, and you got that. Everything's fine. 28, 36. Okay, so he's ahead. We got 30 on silver more on here. 20, 29, not quite. Are you getting ahead here, Foltar? Oh, yeah, big time. Foltar is swinging into the lead. Wowza. Pretty close fight. Fights like that are where your crew skill really come into play. Hey, what's up, Revolver C? Hey, let's do a lurker roll call. We haven't done one tonight. Have you guys noticed any drop frames or anything dropped tonight? Sometimes I get like a false positive on that. It says we've dropped a few frames tonight intermittently, but I haven't noticed anything. But if you're lurking in the chat, me, you're an active watcher, but not an active chatter. Now's your time to make yourself known by posting some of your favorite emotes. Thank you so much for your silent contribution, no matter what you may do in the background. I appreciate you doing homework, relaxing before bed. Whatever you may do, you are awesome. Thanks for making it happen. Holy guacamole, look at that. Shadowbow 19, thanks for the great half year. Wowza woza, look at all those lurkers. Jin Crazy, little hand to you, friend. Welcome to the Dapper. Much love. Yume Penguin, little hand to you as well. Welcome to the Dapper. Wowza woza. Okay, guys, I know we're hyped up right now, but here's what we're going to do. We've been dropping frames, I think, pretty consistently, or consistently enough. We're going to drop the stream for a moment to change servers. So the stream will drop, and it will come right back up in just a very short moment here. Be down probably less than a minute, be my guess. Unless there's any complications. Kale Thunderwing, thanks for the 40 bits. Lurker Love, indeed. So thanks so much for your patience. The stream will return momentarily.